Good morning, class. Today this is the third class of time series analysis. In my previous class, I have discussed with the 3 years and 5 years moving trend. Today I will discuss with 4 years moving average and weighted moving average. And from our next class, I will move on to the straight line fit as seasonal index of that. Okay. So 4 years, you see how the 3 years has been computed. You know. And basically 5 years computed, you know, but what about the fourth year? How you can compute the moving averages of the 4 year? There has been a certain concepts regarding that. I have provided you some in your PDF. If you go through it, you will see that calculate the 4 year moving average of the following year has been given, 2001 to 2010, and Y means the sales has been given. And you have to calculate the 4 year moving average. Okay, see how I am doing. This is sum number 3. Calculation of 4 year moving average. Calculation of 4 year moving averages. Okay. So year has been given and Y means the sales has been given, which is basically the sales. Y means basically the sales. I hope it is clear, right? Yes, it is clear. So year has been given 2001 to 2010, right? 2001, there has to be a space remains. 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009, and 2010. Okay, so the sales has been given 506, 620, 1036. 673, 588, 696, 1116, 738, 663, and 773. Okay. And for 4 year moving total, you need to do first of all 4 year moving total. How you can do it? In case of 4 years, again there has to be 2 years gap, but the amount should be added between the second and the third. Means it should be put over here, it should be put over here, it should be put over here, it should be put over here. Likewise, it should goes on. Okay. Okay. That will be the 4 years total. Total means 506. Next. 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 Next and next. Okay, 4 years total, and you have to put it within second and third. How you can do it? 506 plus 620 plus 1036 plus 673, it is 2835. Okay. Next is 620 plus 1036 plus 673 plus 588. It is 2917. 2917. Next is 1036 plus 673 plus 588 plus 696. 2993. Okay. 2993. Next is 673 plus 588 plus 696 plus 1116. It is 3073. Now 588 plus 696 plus 1116 plus 738. It is 3138. Next 696 plus 1116 plus 738 plus 663. It is coming 3213. There will be a last one, which is 1116 plus 738 plus 663 plus 773. 3290. Now you have to divide it by obviously 4. That will be 4 year moving average. But you have to keep in mind, it has been all considered within the second and the third. Again, likewise, third and fourth within, but there has not been the original year's value. For that, we have to do again 2 year moving total. Okay, first of all, we can do this 2835 divided by 4. We are getting 708.75. Obviously, 2917 divided by 4. 729.25. It is always within 2993 divided by 4. It is 748.25. Now 3073 divided by 4. 768.25. Next is 3138 divided by 4. It is 784.50. Next, 3213 divided by 4, 803.25. And last of not the least, 3290 divided by 4, 822.50. Okay, now you have to calculate 2 years moving total. How you can do that? 2 year moving total. How you can do that? Adding this will transfer the amount in the 2003. Adding this will transfer the amount in 2004. Adding this will transfer the amount in 2005. Adding this to transfer the amount in 2006. Adding this to will transfer the amount 2007. Adding this to will transfer the amount in 2008. Okay. 708.75 plus 729.25 divided by 2. Sorry. It is divided by 2 means it will be the total average, and it is 1438, and 2 year moving average, this divided by 2, it is 719. It is in 2003. Likewise, 729.25 plus 748.25, it is 1477.50, which is divided by 2, it is coming 738.75. Next, 748.25 plus 768.25, it is coming 1516.50 divided by 2, it is 758.25. same wise 768.25 plus 784.5 1552.75 divided by 2, it is coming 776.38. Next, 784.5 plus 803.25, it is 1587.75. 1587.75 divided by 2, it is coming 793.87. 793.87. And the last one, 803.25 plus 822.5, it is coming 1625.75. 1625. It is for 2003. It is for 2008. 1625.75. 2008 is here. 1625.75 is divided by 2. It is coming 812.87. Okay, so this is how the 4-year moving total has to be computed. First of all, you have to calculate the 4 years total, then 4 years moving average, which should be in the second and the third years between. Then you have to transfer to 2-year moving total, which will be exactly the year and 2-year moving average. This is how the 4-year moving averages has to be computed. Next sum which has been given is that from the following series of other observations, calculate 5 years weighted moving average with weights 1, 2, 2, 2, 1. Weights has been given, you have to calculate the respective 5 years moving total. I hope this is clear.
If it is clear,
then I am rubbing it up and I have to calculate 5 years weighted moving average. Okay. So the sum says that computation of, this is sum number 4, I guess, yes, sum number 4, computation of 5-year weighted moving average. How 5 years weighted moving average has been calculated? Year is given, annual sales has been given, which is obviously rupees in 1000. You have to calculate the 5-year weighted moving total, 5-year weighted moving total. I will explain how. First, you write the year from 2001 to 2011. 2001, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. Analysis has been given 2, 6, 1, 5. 2, 6, 1, 5. 6483. Now 5 year weighted moving total means the weights has been given. The weights has been given like 1, 2, 2, 2, 1. How you can calculate? At least 5 years means first two and last two will not be considered. You know that. Now from the third one, how you calculate? Third one, how you can calculate? 1, 2, 2, 2, 1, right? Weight multiplied by value plus 2 into 6 plus 2 into 1 plus 2 into 5 plus 1 into 3. You will get the total like that, same wise. 1 into 6 plus 2 into 1 plus 2 into 5 plus 2 into 3 plus 1 into 7. How you can calculate? These are the actual 5 years, like first 5, next 5, next 5, next 5, next 5, next 5, and finally last 5, with the weights which has been given in the sum. Okay, 2 12 plus 2 14 plus 2 16 plus 10 26 plus 3 29 over here 6 plus 2 8 8 plus 10 18 plus 6 24 plus 7 31. Next will be 1 into 1 plus 2 into 5 plus 2 into 3 plus 2 into 7 plus 1 into 2. Next will be 1 into 5 plus 2 into 3 plus 2 into 7 plus 2 into 2 plus 1 into 6. Next, 1 into 3 plus 2 into 7 plus 2 into 2 plus 2 into 6 plus 1 into 4. Next, 1 into 7 plus 2 into 2 plus 2 into 6 plus 2 into 4 plus 1 into 8. Next, 1 into 2 plus 2 into 6 plus 2 into 4 plus 2 into 8 plus 1 into 3. 1, these are basically the weights which has been given in the sum. 1, 2, 2, 2, 1. And you are computing it with the values. 1 into 2, 2 into 6, 6 oh, 2 into 5, 1, 2 into 5 and 1 into 3. That is how we compute the weighted moving total. So 1, 10 plus 1, 11 plus 6, 17 plus 14, 31 plus 2, 33. This will be 35, 37, calculate 39 and 41, right? And 5 year moving, this is 5 year weighted moving average, right? First two and the last two. 29 divided by 5, it is coming a 1.8. We should divide with 5. Or we should do with the weights? No, we should not go with the 5, because 5 years is definitely, but here it has been considered as 5 year weighted moving average. weighted moving means add the weights 1 plus 2 3 3 plus 2 5 5 plus 2 7 7 plus 1 8 again I am repeatedly telling you if it is mentioned that it is 5 years weighted moving average consider the weights what will be the weight weight is 1 2 2 2 1 add that weight 1 plus 2 3 3 plus 2 5 5 plus 2 7 7 plus 1 8 so it will be 29 divided by 8 31 divided by 8 33 divided by 8 35 divided by 8 37 divided by 8 39 divided by 8 and finally 41 divided by 8 so 29 divided by 8 it is coming 3.625 31 divided by 8 it is coming 3.875 33 divided by 8 it is coming 4.125 35 divided by 8 it is coming 4.375 37 divided by 8 it is coming 4.625 and 39 divided by 8 it is coming 4.875 and 41 divided by 8 it is coming 5.125 so this is your answer if they ask you to calculate weighted moving average then you have to do it like that so I hope this is clear to you this is the third class I hope from the next class I will start with method of least square thank you for patient hearing have a nice day ahead